Hi everyone, this is Autopostrophe. Let's check out an early access title, Demon's Tilt on PC in 4K. Got some options here. The default is fastest, but we want the best quality. Let's check it out. Right, let's take a look at our options here. Looks like the controller doesn't work here. It's all early access, so. Guess that's good enough. Right, let's hit it. I don't know about that music. looks like we have more options inside of this. I got camera auto center. Let's turn that on. The default is to actually be further away from the table. Here, I'll show you what that looks like. Let's see, where was it? Now let's hit this default here. And if we're gonna do more defaults, then auto center was also set or not set. So the scrolling isn't quite as dynamic. It tends to stay a little bit more still in default mode, which I'm not really too fond of. Find it. Different position. This song is not really inspiring me. Looks like the visuals are pretty much spot on, though. But let's go into a more turbo graphics mode. So we'll center the camera. I'm not all that fond of the screen shake. We'll do a much tighter zoom, and the multi-ball will do a little farther out. There we go.
Devolve.
Control the ball with the right triggers, either one of them. Using joystick mode. And then you can tilt the ball with the left stick, give it a little bit more push. Looks like that center function isn't quite there yet, huh? Yeah, I think it lets the ball get too far down to the bottom of the screen, unfortunately. I think the centering has to be set a little harder. But that's one of the hardest things to do, is figure out where the ball should be and then scroll appropriately. I think that's probably why the default is set so much farther away. I kind of lose all the detail with the graphics, and I and some of the danger of playing a video game ball game, where you can't quite see everything. So good. On the sound effects more. Not quite as punchy as it should be. Sounds like these were folks more inspired by the Genesis sound chip, and not the TurboGrafx one, unfortunately, because this is definitely must have played the Mega Drive one. Oh well. I guess not everybody got to play the awesome one on the TurboGrafx. Which makes me sad that the Mega Drive one was somebody's inspiration. Dragon's Crush and Dragon's Fury was quite inferior on the Mega Drive. I mean, I'm glad they made it, because it found a larger audience, obviously, on the Mega Drive. Or an additional audience. I don't know if it ended up being more sales on that system, but there is something about that PC Engine TurboGrafx version. Really special. I wish I had the control scheme, the default control scheme of the TurboGrafx, where your D-pad or your left stick was the left flipper, any button was your right flipper. I think that actually works out better. But of course you can change the control, so you know, this just has to be the default. I think it's a designer's instinct to want to use the flippers for both, but you know, over a long period of play, it's actually not that comfortable. Ball drained, eh? It's infantile humor, believe me. Oh, side flippers is completely useless. You're not even hitting it into. I like that voice. I think they found the sweet spot of that sort of old sound, and still sort of barely making out what the announcer's saying. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nahas. Even like the not the good sounding Genesis sound developers kit, because there was one that was available to Western developers, you know, European developers, North American developers, which is sort of where this sound comes from. But a lot of Japanese developers were developing their own sound development packs, which sounded much, much better. So, like I said, as a it's interesting that they decided to go the route of emulating that sound pack, but it's not the good sound pack. It's like, why would you want to sound like a like Green Dog when you could sound like Revenge of Shinobi? You know? A flipper. Makes it feel cheap. Sinker. Nothing about that. Hit that railing and just break down. Boy, the buttons are not real friendly. Or the controller's not real friendly for navigation. Anyway, this is Autopostrophe. You've been watching Demon's Tilt, occult pinball action, on PC in 4K. I know I was complaining a lot, but I was actually having fun. I think this has a lot of potential. The board is about right. The ball physics are a little hokey here and there, but it is still in early access, so I imagine that they're going to work on that just a tiny bit more. I really feel that they probably need a different music composer and sound engineer. I mean, the music's not very satisfying, unfortunately. You know, I'm sure the artist really worked hard on it, but it just doesn't sound right. You know, and I think the sound effects can be a lot punchier. But the game itself is really good. So I would suggest that that folks pick it up and support this development. I know I have and will. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching. I will see you at the next stream.